Hi everybody, it's Dandruff with the news cartridge for Thursday, July 27th, 2017. Welcome to Thursday and thank you for joining me during my stream last night, though I did end up playing PUBG instead. Today begins with some news that has been a long time coming. The Call of Duty Modern Warfare Remaster is now available for purchase as a standalone game. Free on Xbox One this weekend is Diablo 3 Ultimate Evil Edition, and you have until August 1st to play it as much as you want. Coming to Nintendo Switch is LEGO Worlds, releasing on September 8th. Also coming to the Switch is Lumo, the isometric puzzle game, but no release date has been confirmed just yet. The side-scrolling adventure RPG, known as Wuppo, is coming to Xbox One and PS4 sometime during September, again with no specific release date mentioned. If you love digital card games on the go, and I know you do, Bethesda has released a mobile version of The Elder Scrolls Legends on both Android and iOS, and it's free to play just like the PC version. Loki, who got an update after mentioning it yesterday, Friday the 13th has an update live, but only on Xbox One. The Nubia DLC is now out for Civ 6, along with the summer update, which adds restart button to make mulligans easier, and also auto-selects the last route for traders. Ubisoft revealed today that For Honor would be getting dedicated servers, along with a new 4v4 PvP mode, and I would have to say that I am not a fan of the current one. I think that the 1v1 or the 2v2 are much better. This is the second game that I've seen Ubisoft use this logic. The first one was Rainbow Six Siege with Operation Health. It's kinda like this. Hey, Ubi boss, I've got a really cool idea for a video game. What do you think?
We like it, and we'll make it, but we won't make it run well until after it's been out for a while.
Moving on from there was a rumor that Rockstar was doing some motion capture work for GTA 6, or possibly Red Dead Redemption 2, but the actor in question, Tim Neff, says that he was not a part of it. This comes from Neff's own resume, where it indicates that he not only worked on Red Dead 2, but also GTA 6. It's suspected that this is a typo because he did work on GTA 5. And then I can't believe that this is actually a thing, but here is KFC and Mountain Dew's collaboration of a box filled with chicken, a game controller on each side, and a place to hold your cell phone. I have no words for this. As ridiculous as that may have been, this one is too, but for a completely different reason, as a sealed copy of the NES version of Mario Brothers has sold for a whopping $30,000. Well, there you go. All you have to do is find a hit game, do not open it for 32 years, and then boom! Instant profit. In Overwatch news, Doomfist is now live on all three platforms, so let me know how you think he plays in the comment section down below. And then some changes are coming to the public test realm in the form of Junkrat getting buffed. His concussion mine ability specifically is getting tweaked, with two current options that Blizzard is considering, as well as buffing his ultimate, which, to be fair, has never been the same since the Junkenstein Halloween event. And that brings us to our final topic today, which is once again, a game has been pulled down from Steam, but for a reason I don't think has been featured on my show yet. Pornography. House Party's title is self-explanatory. You go to a house as a male character, and you get yourself into some sexy situations, to the delight of your naughty bits. It sold relatively well, with around 35,000 copies nestled into Steam libraries around the world, including many popular streamers and YouTubers. Valve is offering developer Eek Games to change their game in order to better fit their terms of service. What could be violating these terms are things like the ability to whip out your penis at will, or perhaps the usage of certain logos like Facebook, Reddit, Jack Daniels, Sony, and Hearthstone. The reason why I can show you these logos is because it's covered under fair use, because I'm trying to inform. I am not trying to directly sell a product, which Eek Games clearly is. Personally, I have no problem with a sex party game, and the developer states that they don't want to censor anything that they don't have to, and will be delivering an uncensored version through different means in the future. Hey Eek, could you let me know where to get that uncensored version? It's for a friend. Let me know if you've played House Party or what you think of sex games in the comment section down below. Something, something, tomorrow's game releases. For PC, Super Lovely Planet, Primal Lands, Professor Watt's Memory Match, Shapes and Colors, Deadly Edge, Mars 2030, Galaxy Annihilation, Tank Battle Pacific, Cybermotion, Super Block Break 3D, Gulu, C4 and Amiga Classics Remakes 6-Pack, Solar Gun, Sundered, Glowing Sokoban, Machine World 2, Car Mechanic Simulator 2018, Heaven and Earth, Shapes, Legend of Alaria, The Wizards, Paint Pool, Mysteries of Fence, Tales of the Tiny Planet, Quest Hunter, Remnants of a Beautiful Day 2012, Far Space, Battlefield Alliance, Randomizator, Princess Evangile, W Happiness, Steam Edition, Businessman, Sunrise Survival, Gaia 2200, Tailwind, Arena, Gray's Counter, Crazy Car, Infested Nation, and The Hunting God. For PlayStation 4, Sundered, Rugby League Live 4, and Constructor. For Xbox One, Super Cloud Build, Cyber Complex, and Rugby League Live 4. For Nintendo Switch, Namco Museum, and Ultra Hyper Ball. For Nintendo 3DS, Hey Pikmin, and Miitopia. For PlayStation Vita, Collar X Malice, and It's Spring Again. Thank you very much, everybody. This has been News Cartridge. I am Dandruff. I will see you tomorrow. And I used to be addicted to soap, but I'm clean now. Today has not gone well. Today is not going very well. So I got my show done yesterday early. It was actually done rather on time. It didn't get uploaded, late as fuck as it usually does. So I was able to stream last night, and I streamed PUBG. I was going to stream some Kingdoms and Castles, because I had to do that for Keymailer and whatnot. And I just stayed up till like 2 in the morning playing PUBG. And then I went to bed, and I woke up, and I woke up at like noon or so. And yeah, that's when everything just started going to hell. Everything was fine up until so everything was really going good today, except for the podcast that I was on may not be uploaded tomorrow. And what sucks about that is normally it's like, okay, whatever, you did some content, you talked to friends or whatever, it's fine, you know, it didn't get uploaded, no big deal. I had a really good podcast today. I was like, I got done with that podcast thinking like, man, that was really good. I was on the ball. Everything was so good. I told the wife Druff today, you know, when I'm on that podcast, I pull out amazing stuff. I am on it. Stuff that I'm doing is just pure gold. And then the audio got corrupted. I don't know if the audio's okay. I don't think that it's going to go up tomorrow. And I really feel like we tackled some good issues. We went over some really, really good stuff. I was able to, like, throw out some counterpoints, some counterarguments. I defended Niantic at some places. At other places, I was like, but what the fuck, Niantic? So don't give me, I'm not a Niantic defender. I think Niantic needs to improve their shit, but they don't deserve all the flack they got for the Pokemon Go Fest. I'm pretty sure you've seen that in the previous episodes of my show. If you haven't, you probably want to watch, I don't know, one of the last few episodes. I think that was on Monday. Yeah, that was Monday's episode. Yeah, I don't know. I hope it'll go up. Hopefully it'll be able to be fixed or something. Hopefully it can be chopped down. I don't know, though. I don't know the status of it. I got to talk to Musical Antihero and see what he has to say. Thank you, I Am Patty Jack, for the little bit of extra information that you gave me today. There'll be a link to his channel down below, too. I Am Patty Jack does pretty much the same thing I do. He covers a lot of video game news, hot topics that are going around. But like most people, I'm the only crazy guy who's like, I need to cover at least 12 things in a day. He usually covers one or two things. That seems to be the smarter way of doing things, but I've got myself locked into doing crazy amounts of work all the time. I can't say I don't love it. I fucking love doing it. It keeps me out of getting myself in trouble. Keeps me always looking for more stuff than just the one or two topics. Granted, I know people out there, I'm not going to railroad people and say that they only look for those two topics or whatever. But I'm trying to do as much as I can. I Am Patty Jack is awesome. Go check out his channel. He's way funnier than me. He's way funnier than I could ever be. Along with Musical Antihero, go check him out too. Gamer Z was on the podcast because we needed a third. Bill Miller wasn't able to go in. His name was iHeart Anime. Musical Antihero, me, and Gamer Z this time. Hopefully we'll be able to go up. I don't know. So that sucks. What else is going on? PUBG. PUBG is fucking amazing. PUBG is really, really good. I'm having a ton of fun with that. I'm having fun with it playing by myself even. It's a lot more fun with friends, but it is even fun by yourself. So if you like shooters at all, I recommend picking it up. Recommend checking it out if you haven't checked it out already. If you're interested in it, it's a ton of fun. It's a lot of fun. Kingdoms and Castles 2, a lot of fun game. Been so many good games this year. I can't believe how many good games there have been this year. This has been one of the best years in gaming I think I have ever seen, followed by one of the worst years in gaming I have ever seen. So, wow, cool. At least I'm happier this year. 2015 was really good. 2016 sucked. 2017, oh my gosh. I got a couple comments yesterday that the end card was a little bit rambly, and I agree, it kind of was. So we're just going to end it right here. I've been feeling a little bit all over the place lately. Hopefully I'll be able to get more on focus over the weekend. I don't know. I don't know what it is. I don't know. You know, life. Social media links are over here, everybody. Thank you so much for watching. Click over here to subscribe to my channel. Click over here to watch yesterday's episode where we talked about Illphonics, the developers of Friday the 13th, working on another game already called Dead Alliance. Dead Alliance? I think it's Dead Alliance. I don't know how they're doing it. Bye, everybody. Bye.